everyone. Welcome to the Essex Sport Facebook page. My name's Arlene. We have a 30-minute yoga session for you today. If you want to grab some water if you'd like, some nearby, just make sure you've got plenty of space to move around freely, and you can grab a yoga mat or a Pilates mat or something, cushions on a floor that's not slippery, just nice and secure. All right, so I just encourage you to do any of the movements today that feel comfortable for you, and you can take a rest at any time in child's pose if that feels right for today. Okay, great. So we're going to start coming to lay back on the mat. So just come to find a comfortable position. And as you come to settle into the mat, just make those adjustments to feel as comfortable as possible. So just notice if you'd like your arms out to the side, if you'd like to have your legs straight or your knees bent. Just observe the comfortable position today for you. So see if your arms are comfortable. Do you like having one hand on your belly, one hand on your heart, or palms up or down? Good. And as you come to settle into the mat, just notice all those points where you touch the ground. So you can notice the parts of your feet and your legs and your shoulders that touch the ground. And just think about the inhalation, your inhalation and exhalation. So as you inhale, you can feel where the air enters and the parts of your body that move with your breath, and let your breath be natural without effort today. So just the natural rise and fall of your breath. And as you do so, think about that space between your eyebrows. Does it feel relaxed? Is there tension there? And just let your breath flow over your skin to the muscles of your face. And as you exhale, you can soften. Now as you inhale, think about the breath rising lower. So it might rise from your navel up to your rib cage, all the way to your collarbones. And then as you exhale, soften and relax. Think about your left hip and your right shoulder next. So as you inhale, feel the breath rise from your left hip up your middle body, all the way in a diagonal to your right shoulder. And it's almost like they begin to expand in a diagonal away from each other. And as you exhale, soften and relax into the mat. Now think about your right hip and your left shoulder, a diagonal as you inhale, rising from your right hip up through your rib cage to your left shoulder. They expand in a diagonal away from each other. And as you exhale, softening and contracting. And now think about your breath from your belly, up past your navel to your heart space, and perhaps the breath rises up through your chest to across your nose to the top of your head. And when you exhale, soften and relax into the mat. Good. And just feel your body as a whole. Just notice if you feel tension anywhere. And when you're ready, you can start to reconnect with your body. You might wiggle your fingers and toes, or just very slowly start to turn your head side to side. So just gently begin to reconnect with your body as you desire. And when it feels right, you can start to bend your knees and place your feet on the floor comfortably. And just notice how that feels today for your body. And we'll just do a little pelvic tilt to start. So you can place your hands where they're comfortable, whether that be on your belly or out to the side. And as you inhale, just start to draw your navel inward. So it's like your tailbone tips upwards. And then as you exhale, relax the breath. And your tailbone tips down. So inhale, draw your navel inward, tailbone tipping up. And as you exhale, relax your belly, like your tailbone relaxes towards the ground, kind of creating a little arch in your lower back. So one more round, inhale, navel draws inward, tailbone or hips tilt upwards. And as you exhale, rounding your belly, lower back massages towards the ground. Good. And now we'll take a nice full body stretch, so just lengthen your legs. And bring your arms overhead, and if it's comfortable, flex your feet and imagine your heels are trying to reach the opposite wall and your fingers try to reach overhead. Just feel that nice long length that creates both in your spine and your side body. Then as you exhale, you can start to bring one knee to your chest. If it's intense having the other leg straight, you can bend that knee. Good. So I'm bringing my right knee to chest to see what feels right for you. You can hold your shin or your thigh. Think about kind of having your hip comfortable, your leg in a comfortable position. It might be about the width of your hip. If you want more, you can lift your forehead upwards towards your knee. Just see how that feels. Relax your hips evenly to the ground. Check in that your jaw feels relaxed. Good. good. And then we'll release that leg and switch and do the other one. So through your full body stretch in the center, you might flex your feet or point your toes, see which one you prefer. And then as you exhale, we'll bring the other knee to your chest. Hold shin or thighs, that's comfortable. If you want more, you can lift up. Just notice where that feels nice. Relax your hips, your touching points on the ground. Good, and then we'll take another full body stretch. Inhale, as you exhale, both knees to your chest. You can do that one at a time or both at the same time, just see what you prefer. And a little rock side to side for a moment. Good, so keep one knee bent. I'm gonna keep my right knee bent and place my left foot on the floor. Open your knee out to the side and rest your ankle on the opposite side. So I've got my right knee out to the side and I'm resting my right ankle on my left thigh. And just start to bring a little rock side to side, right to left, into that move, into your lower legs, or your legs, they're always on lower, aren't they? And just notice how that feels. You can go with the rhythm that feels nice for you. And notice how that feels. Is there a little massage effect on the ground? Perhaps a lengthening on the side? So if you, like me, have your right knee up, you might notice when your foot comes towards the floor on the left, there's kind of a lengthening along your right side, and the opposite as well. Maybe there's a little rotation you can feel in your spine. Okay, so we'll swap and do the other side. So just bringing that foot to the floor, and then the other leg. Foot lifts, knee out to the side, ankle resting on your thigh. And once that's in place, you can just make little shuffles so your hips feel even, and just find that little rock again. So you can go at the pace that feels comfortable for you. So maybe this is, it's faster or slower than what I'm doing. Just feel, see what feels nice. What does your body like in this moment? And where does that create ease? And you might like to do that slower and kind of hold one side to the other, or maybe you like that more kind of motion of rocking side to side. So just notice what feels lovely for your body. Good, and then when you're ready, we'll come back to the center. Take another full body stretch to see if you like that with, prefer that with flexed feet or pointed toes. You can feel that length that creates in your spine. And as you exhale, again, both knees to chest, hold your shins. Little massage if desired by circling knees on ceiling. And then you can either roll to one side or rock up from here. Just see which is nice. Good, we'll come to all fours on hands and knees. Good, so as you come up to all fours, just set up so your hands are about the width of your shoulders and your wrists are under your shoulders. It might be about two fists between your knees, so you can notice them alignment as well, of knees under hips. Good, from here, relax your hips over to the right side, and then you can look over your right shoulder. Good, and notice how that creates like an arch. Like if you were looking from above, there's a C in your spine, and it helps to relax the left rib cage. Good, and also kind of contract or shorten the right side of your rib cage. Good, and then we'll come back to center, and then do the other side. So just at your own pace, hips over to the left, and then you look over left shoulder, and just feel like your breath almost expands into your right rib cage. Good, and then we'll come back to center. Good, so next, if you exhale and slowly bring your right forearm down, but then turn your head to the left. So just notice how that feels. It creates a little rotation through your lower back, your mid back, and all the way up to your shoulders and neck. Good, then we'll come up, straighten both arms, then do the other side. So right arm stays straight, left elbow bends to bring the forearm down. Turn your head to the away from your forearm that's on the ground. So left forearm's down, turning my head to the right, and just notice how that feels through your lower back. Little nice rotation. Good, and then we'll come back up to all fours. Practice a puppy dog pose next. So keep your hips above your knees, and just very slowly start to walk your hands forward. You can adjust how much space is between your hands, and stop at any point here. So at maximum, you might bring your forehead down towards the ground and maintain that long spine. If it's comfortable, you can either imagine your tailbone kind of lengthens to that wall behind you, or you might give your hips a little wiggle like a, this is called puppy dog pose, so you might give a little wiggle of your hips side to side, like a puppy might do. And just make it comfortable on your shoulders here. So if you prefer, if you have your head elevated, you might like to do that with a little block or cushion underneath your forehead to rest, if that feels, that support feels nice. Good, but perhaps that feels like it's creating length throughout your spine, but particularly in your lower back. And then when you're ready, we'll walk, lift up, walk your hands back to all fours. Good, and just come to rest in child's pose from all fours for a moment. So bottom comes to your heels, slowly bring upper body down. Any support for forehead with a fist or two, or maybe the ground. And just see if you prefer your arms overhead reaching towards the front of the mat. You might prefer that in a V if that's more comfortable on the shoulders. Or you might even, if that's creating tension,
to relax your hands either side of your feet. Just stay there for a few breaths. And just think about if you were a seed and the ground is soil, and you just start to kind of relax into the mat, like you're just nestling into the ground. Good. So one more breath here. Lovely. And then when you're ready, you can bring your hands back either side of your head, come up through all fours. We'll just set up for downward facing dog, okay? So just from all fours, tuck your toes, slowly bring your bottom to your heels. Imagine your hands are in kind of soft clay and they just melt into the ground. And just imagine there's a tailbone. You have a tailbone, hopefully. But imagine there's a string on your tailbone and it lifts your tailbone up. Good. And then just see how that feels. You're welcome to keep your knees bent. You might start to bend one knee at a time to bring that little bicycling effect in. You can also start to lift both heels and lower down, or if it's nice today, you feel like this movement of your legs, you might come into flying dog, lifting one leg. You can bring that knee towards your navel and straighten your leg again, and just do that at your own pace. So you might do the other leg as well if this feels intense, so continue with that if that's nice. But if it's intense, of course, please come to child's pose at any time, which also creates that lovely long spine. You can notice how it's almost like they're your hips are drawn back towards the wall behind you, and that encourages my arms next to ears. Good, to create the long spine. Lovely. So just play with that for another round of breath. And then when you're ready, we'll walk hands to feet or feet to hands. Come to stay in forward fold for a few breaths. If you're in child's pose, come up through all fours and you can walk your hands to your feet or vice versa. And see if you like to have your knees bent here with forearms on thighs, or you might rest your hands anywhere on your legs that feels nice today. Just check in, is the weight in your right foot more than your left? Does it feel like it's kind of rolling outwards or rolling inwards? And can you make those little adjustments so it feels like the weight's even throughout your feet? And you can start to think about your upper body like a rag doll or a willow tree, just kind of softening towards the ground. And then allows, although there might be a bend in your knees here, just see what feels comfortable, that allows your sitting bones to lengthen upwards and create a little bit of a release, perhaps through the back of your legs and your lower back. Okay, one more breath here. And when you're ready, start to bend your knees, draw your navel inward, roll up to standing slowly. Good. Then as you come upright, just start to look up towards the ceiling, and then we'll slowly start to bring our chin towards our chest. And just do that twice more. So just slowly gaze up as much as feels comfortable, and then chin towards chest. Relax perhaps the back of your neck there, and once more. Okay, so stand with your feet about the width of your hip bones here. So the sides of the feet might be parallel with the sides of the mat. Imagine there's you're at the beach, someone's buried your feet, so they're not going to move, but you're trying to draw your heels towards each other. So that can, as you draw your heels towards each other, your feet stay. You can feel that engage your inner thighs and your bottom. Good, then rest your hands by your side. Start to turn your palms forward. If it's comfortable, you can continue that rotation through your shoulders to turn your palms out to the side. So maybe the fingers, little fingers towards the front and your thumbs towards the back. Okay, and just notice how that might change the sensations in your chest or your posture today. Good. And then when you're ready, you can relax your arms, relax your legs, and give everything a little shake. Okay, so we're going to practice two balances next. So for the first one, just see if we're going to stand on one leg. So you can come off mat or stand near a wall if that's preferable. See if you'd like to start with that hip width stance, or you might prefer to start with your feet next to each other. Think about that alignment of shoulders stacked above your hips and your hips above your knees and knees above ankles. Good, so just choose one leg. I'm going to shift the weight to my left leg, and just notice that weight shifts towards your standing leg first. Hips stay level, knee bends. And then we're going to imagine that there's a string on this knee and it's just drawn upwards. So as an option one, just lift your toes off the floor. You can bring them back at any time, down towards the floor at any time. Option two, that string drawing your knee up towards the ceiling. Good, hands can be on your hips or out to the side. Good, and then if you'd like to, you can challenge your balance a little bit by bending your elbows and creating this chin mudra by your index finger and thumb touching to make a circle, and your three fingers, the other fingers, are lengthening away. So if you want to stay wherever that's comfortable, adjust at any time. If you want to challenge your balance a bit further, you can start to rotate from your waist towards your bent knee. Okay, so just come into that as much as feels comfortable. You can turn your head, and even more challenging is to turn your head towards the wall behind you.
Good, so just see what that feels comfortable. So just make adjustments, come out at any time. Good. And when you're ready, so no rush, we'll start to release out of the posture. So if you are rotated, you might come forward, straighten your leg with your heel lengthening away, and then lower your leg. And make any little adjustments, shake out. Once you've released your body, a little shake it as an option. And just notice how you might feel differently, right side to left. Do you feel kind of lower, your leg closer to the floor, your foot more in contact with the ground on one side or the other? So just notice for a moment, scanning right side to left, any differences. And then we'll set up to do the other side. So just come into that at your own pace. So you know the same options. We'll talk you through them. Just as a reminder, so hips stay level, shift the weight over towards the other side as you're towards your standing leg. Knee that's bending, the opposite one we did before. You can flex your foot. Maybe there's that strain drawing your knee upwards, hands on your hips or out to the side, or maybe elbows bending and taking that chin mudra. Stay here if that's comfortable. Foot down at any time. Optional rotation, just when it feels right for you, so there's no rush. And you can turn your head to that wall behind you to challenge your balance further. Good. So there's kind of a rotation for in both directions. Good. And just notice how that feels. Come out at any time. Lovely. And then when you're ready, you can very slowly start to rotate forward and relax your legs straight, relax down, and give everything a little shake. Okay. So for the next one, we're going to practice Warrior 3. And just stand with your feet again about that hip width stance. I'm just going to turn this to the sides. If you do have yoga blocks handy, you might have one nearby. I'll just grab one of mine as a demonstration, but there's lots of options without it. Okay. So hands on your hips to start, and just imagine, shift the weight over towards one leg. I'm shifting to my left. Imagine there's a string drawing your heel, so your heel comes straight, your right leg's, your heel comes straight behind your shoulder. Good, and then, so option one, you can lift your toes off the floor and just see how that feels and bring them back up at any time. Option two, imagine that string on your heel starts to draw you further. The string is drawing your heel further to that wall behind you. So stop at any time here, so there's no pressure to come into it deeply. You might like your hands on your hips or resting on your lower back or arms out to the side. More challenging to have your arms overhead. If you'd like to, you can continue to hinge forward. So that block, you can place that on the floor to rest your hands on. If you like having that kind of chest parallel to the ground, and you can start to reach one arm at a time away and in any direction. So just see how that feels for you. That one was a bit more challenging. One arm overhead and one arm behind for me. Okay, that's wow. Okay, lovely. So when you're ready, come out at any time. You can start to draw your toes, like there's a string on your toes and they're drawn straight forward. Good, lovely. And then when you're ready, open your arms up to the side. We'll stand with our feet about hip width apart. Again, just do this position called the skin gorilla. So you can bring your arms up overhead, inhale, exhale, sit as if to chair. Let your arms relax down and just continue. Do a few more rounds at your own pace. And that's a nice way to relax the lower back. And just bring a bit of movement to your shoulders, your hip joints. Good, so we'll do one more. Lovely. Okay, so we'll set up to do Warrior 3 on the other leg. So I'll just change my positioning so my working leg is closer to you. So feet about the width of your hips. Come into this at your own pace. So shift the weight over to the side for your standing leg. So my right leg is my standing leg. That string idea or imagery, drawing my left heel behind my shoulder. Optional one, toes lift. Option two, string drawing my heel straight behind me. So that helps to keep my hips kind of facing forward and my knee forward. Again, wherever that's comfortable, so you don't have to come into that too deeply. Just if it's comfortable. Again, you can bring your hands to, it doesn't have to be a block, a little stool or pile of books that won't slide. Good, so wherever that's comfortable. I think that challenging one for me was one arm in front and one arm behind. Good. So just come into that at your own pace. You can play with how close your chin is towards your chest too, to elongate the back of your neck, along with your spine. Good, so when you're ready, come out at your own pace, so no rush. You can bend your knee a little bit if this is, side is more challenging. It seems like it is for me today. So your toes, imagine there's a string on your toes drawing forward, and we'll come back to that skiing gorilla again. So inhale, arms up, exhale, sit as if to chair. Good, and we'll just do two more.
being gorillas. Good. Lovely. And then if you come to stand comfortably with your feet about the width of your hips, we'll place our hands on your hips and just start to do a little circle with your hips. So you're bringing your hips forward to the side and behind you. Okay, so just do two in one direction, two circles in one direction, and then go in the other direction. Good. And just notice how that feels. Maybe it creates a little release through your lower back or your hips, a little bit of movement. Okay, so now think about keeping your hips stationary. And you're going to start to lean to the side, come forward. So we're just circling the upper body. So two circles in one direction. Just again, do that at the range that feels comfortable. And you can play with looking upwards or looking downwards at different positions of that circling. So just see how that feels for you, if it's nice. Good. Okay, lovely. So we'll come back to the center. You can give everything a little shake or massage out your feet. Okay, so we're going to come down towards the ground in a squat position next. So if you turn your toes out to the side and just take a few bends of your knee to see if that's comfortable tracking for your knee about to the center of your foot. Okay, so we'll place our hands in front of our heart and just feel your shoulders over your hips. So there's a nice alignment. Feel the breath rising and falling here from your navel to your heart and your heart to your navel. Lovely. And then when you're ready, just very slowly start to bend your knees. We'll come down to a squat. We're going to come to stand up again in a moment. So just stop wherever that's comfortable. You might bring your elbows inside of your knees. You might have your heels lift. It's all fine. You can bring a little support, like a rolled up towel or some yoga blocks or something underneath your heels, if that feels more comfortable. Okay, so we're going to come up to standing again. So push your feet. Imagine the top of your head has a string, so you're lifting up. Really good. Lovely. And relax our arms down. And just step your legs into a straddle position. So you might change the position of your feet so your toes are forward and the sides of your feet are parallel with the sides of the mat. But we still feel shoulders over hips. Okay. We're going to bring our arms behind you. So option one, you can bend your elbows, hands on your hips. Option two, rest your hands on your tailbone. Option three, you can interlace your fingers behind you. And if you'd like to come into that deeper, rotate your shoulders. And almost imagine if you add that rotation of shoulders, that your knuckles are kind of lengthening towards the floor. Okay, so if it's comfortable, you can start to look up a bit. So just come into that as much as feels comfortable. It's almost like a little upper back bend. So be kind to your neck and your shoulder blades. Good. Just see how that feels. Nice way to kind of open that space in the chest, particularly if you work on a computer watch or use a mobile device. Sometimes that kind of rounds our shoulders forward. It's a nice way to counter it, so you can take a little break at any time in your day if you are on the computer much. Okay, lovely. So we'll keep our arms as they are. If that's comfortable, just adjust them at any time to feel right for you. So shoulders over hips, long spine and neck. Navel engages inward a little bit. So imagine the top of your head lengthens to the ceiling. And as you exhale, slowly hinge forward. So maintain that long spine. So we're just folding from the hip space where the thigh meets the hips. So just stop wherever that feels comfortable. Just journey slowly. So at maximum, you might have the top of your head relaxed towards the floor. You're welcome to have a little bend in your knees as much as feels comfortable for you. Or if it feels right, if your legs are straighter, you can start to feel the sitting bones lengthening upwards. So just stay for a few breaths. Come out at any time or adjust to feel comfortable. If you do feel any tension in your shoulders or neck, you're welcome to turn your head side to side. Like I said, necks. I only have one neck that I'm aware of. Okay, ready. When you're ready, we'll slowly push through our feet, hinge up to standing, top of the head lengthening away. Good, lovely. You can relax hold of your fingers, give everything a little shake, step your feet together. Good, and then we're going to reach our arms in front of us, just about the height of your shoulders, and then flex the palms of your hands. So, like you're saying stop. Good, and then we'll do the opposite, so slowly rotate so your fingertips are towards the floor. Good, lovely. And then we'll come through kind of a chair pose to come down towards the ground. So just stand with your feet about hip width apart, lead with your tailbone, exhale, sit to chair. Good, arms can be overhead. If that's intense, you can bring them out to the side or place them on your hips. Just check in, does it feel like a nice width between your feet? Maybe your knees start to track about to the center of your foot. You can make those little adjustments to the width of your feet to feel comfortable or the placement of your heels. Good, and then we're going to come towards a forward folded position. So hinge forwards, you can stop at any point here. Again, arms where they're comfortable, chest parallel to the floor. Good,
And then we're going to relax our arms and just kind of rotate through your shoulder sockets to just relax there. And you might turn your head side to side. We'll transition to a forward folded position now. So you're welcome to have your hands on your legs or the floor. You can use a block here as well. But start to straighten your legs. So it's like the back of your legs just soften into that space behind you. Very slowly, stop when it feels right. So you can maintain a bend in your knee if you want support. It's nice to rest your hands on a block or on your legs. If you want to come into it deeper, maybe start to hinge from your hips, and you can hold onto your toes or rest the palms of your hands underneath your feet, or bring your forearms behind your calf muscles. Just come into that as much as feels comfortable for you. But just feeling the breath relax. If there's any tension again in your breath, just make those adjustments, maybe come out a little bit from the posture. So think about where the edge of tension arises. So just trying to stop before that edge of tension, just before it, a maximum. So just do what feels right for you. Good. And when you're ready, we'll very slowly start to bend our knees. Come down towards the floor. Okay. And lay on your back with your knees bent, please. Okay, so we're going to lay back. Knees bent, feet about the width of your hips. So two options for the next one. So if you've practiced a shoulder stand before, you're welcome to practice that if you're something you're comfortable doing. Another option is to practice bridge pose, which is really lovely for the spine. So for bridge, feet about hip width apart, hands either side of your hips. Inhale, draw your navel inward, tailbone tips up. And you can start to lift your hips up towards the ceiling, as high as feels comfortable. So come down at any time. It's quite nice to keep your neck in the center, like your gaze upwards, so that there's not a turn in your neck. Good. If you want to come into that deeper, you can tuck your shoulder blades under and interlace your fingers below you. Or you can play with bringing your arms out to the side if that feels comfortable and appropriate, or arms overhead. So come in and out of bridge as feels right for you, or you can explore shoulder stand if that's something you've practiced before. Okay, so another option in bridge is to lift one foot off the floor, and you can flex your foot and lengthen your heel away from you and hold for a few breaths. And you can, when it feels right, swap and do the other leg. So just do the legs even amount of times. Again, come down at any time to relax your vertebrae down, one at a time, if that feels right. Good. So just stay here for another breath, and just notice, where is that comfortable? Perhaps you feel your knees lengthening away from you. You feel that transfer of weight towards your shoulder blades, soften your neck into the mat, so there's no strain there. Good. So when you're ready, we'll start to think about coming out. So if you're in shoulder stand, support your spine fully and roll down. Same with our bridge. Very slowly start to relax. If you're still in the posture, one vertebrae down at a time. And when you do feel your hips come in contact with the ground, you can start to bring your feet away from the floor. And just find a rocking motion that feels nice for you. So you can rock side to side. You might draw circles on the ceiling with your knees in either direction. If you've been in shoulder stand, sometimes it's quite nice to rock forwards and backwards. You can do this for the bridge as well. Good. Another option for rocking is to hold your toes and kind of, it's almost like a plow pose, like, or maybe a variation of happy baby and plow. Just rocking forwards and backwards, holding your toes, and just do what feels nice for you. So just take any variation. You can even come to a little happy baby pose here. Okay, so after you've had a nice little rock, or rolling around, to see what feels nice, we'll come to a stillness and do a little rotation next. So knees stay bent, either feet on the floor or arms out to the side. So option one, as you exhale, slowly lower your knees over to the side. So I'm bringing my knees over to the right. If you want to come into that a little bit deeper, you can bring your left thigh on top of your right with your knees bent, and then slowly relax your knees over to the side. So just see what feels nice for you. If it's more comfortable, you can place cushions here underneath your knees. If you want more, maybe straightening your upper leg. See if you like to hold on your toes, and you can even turn your head away from your knees for a deeper rotation. But just find a few moments of stillness wherever that's comfortable, and imagine that the breath is like a bellow, starting to expand your rib cage to the side here. So you can relax through your hip, your lower back, your rib cage, your chest. Good. And then when you're ready, very slowly bend your knees and come to center. Good. And just do the other side. So same options. Maybe both knees bent, deeper rotation with one thigh on top of the other, and bring your knees over the side, or you might straighten
the upper leg. You can even straighten both legs if that's comfortable. See where it feels nice for your arm. If you notice your shoulder lifting away from the floor, if you have some cushions or pillows, you can place that under there, or you can even bend your elbows. So that kind of helps to relax the shoulder downwards. Good, so just see where that feels nice for you. Where would you like to turn your head? And just feel the breath again, almost like that. Your rib cage. Your rib cage is a bellow, inflating to the side. Good. So no rush to come out. When you're ready, you might start to bend your knees a little and slowly roll onto your back. And just make any movement that feels comfortable for you. So you might take another full body stretch, either toes pointed or feet flexed, or maybe a little windshield wiper for your knees to kind of do additional rotation for the spine. So whatever feels nice for you. And then just come to find a comfortable position, just to turn inward for a moment and notice how you feel. So you might place one hand on your belly or one hand on your heart, or have your arms out to the side. And just come to feel the flow of your breath, your energy. And just scan and notice how your feet feel, your legs, your hands and arms, your shoulders, your back, the muscles of your face. Do they feel different, more relaxed, softer? Do you feel like your breath has changed at all? Just notice. And you're welcome to stay here longer. So just when you do find that you'd like to move again, you can wiggle your fingers and toes and just start to reconnect with your body. But thank you for practicing yoga with me today. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. And feel free to check out the other videos we have on Facebook, on the Essex Sport YouTube page, and you can send over any questions you might have by email or on Facebook Messenger. All right, so thank you. Have a wonderful day.